Hello, Odooers, and welcome back. Pop quiz. We're going to play a game of, is it a warehouse or a location? So consider this. Is the freezer area that stores ice cream a warehouse or a location? Correct. It's a location. A location is anywhere a product can be, like a shelf, floor, aisle, or customer location. They're used to organize the flow of incoming and outgoing goods. Now, what about a warehouse? A warehouse is a physical place with a physical address, an actual building where your items are stocked. Here's a tip. One warehouse has one address. For the most part, a typical warehouse has a designated inbound area, storage area, outbound area, and as many locations as needed to smoothly organize the flow of incoming and outgoing goods. In Odoo, these locations are structured hierarchically. What this means is that for a child location, like warehouse slash stock slash zone A, zone A is located inside the parent location warehouse slash stock, which is located inside the warehouse, aka WH. The locations are organized in a tree-like structure with the warehouse at the top. Alrighty, I know that was a lot, Odooers, so let's jump into our database to see how warehouses and locations work. Alrighty, let's go ahead and start in our inventory overview. First, it should be noted that in order to keep track of locations, we need the storage locations feature enabled. We can do that by going to the configuration subheading and clicking on settings. Then we can scroll down to the warehouse subheading at the bottom and make sure that storage locations is checked. Okay, now let's go ahead and click save on the top left. And now I want to view a list of different locations within my warehouse. I can go there by going to the configuration subheading again and selecting locations. This brings us to the location list. The existing internal locations are marked in red and contain everything that is considered my stock. If you look closely at the names of the locations, they all feature the prefix warehouse slash stock. Each row under warehouse slash stock are child locations, which are specific storage locations for products in our warehouse. Now, let's say I need a new location just for our popular Stealthy Wood mug. To do that, I'll click New, and that brings us to the location form. Let's go ahead and type the name of this location, which is Favorite. In the parent location field, I'll choose Warehouse slash Stock, which encompasses all storage locations. Awesome. And in the location type field, we'll keep it as is. Now we're done creating this new location. But don't forget this one valuable lesson. Before you go off into the world, Odooers, try to avoid having too many children, locations that is. That's because it's hard to maintain and use daily. If you have to look for a really granular location like row A slash shelf B slash rack C, that is a lot of work. So if you're interested in learning more about other fields and options on this page, I'd suggest checking out the documentation linked below. All right, let's learn more about location types by clicking on the location's breadcrumb. And I'll remove the internal filter here at the top. And would you look at that? There are a lot more locations to choose from now. Let's take a look at the location types column. Each of these location types help Odoo understand where products at these locations are and what to do with them. It also tells us where products come from, like if they're from vendors, customers, shop floors, and so on. For example, Odoo only counts products that are currently in the red internal locations and transit locations for inventory valuation. A customer location is where products sold can be viewed. Products here are no longer available in stock. A transit location, like physical location slash inter-warehouse transit, is used for intercompany or inter-warehouse operations to track products shipped between these different addresses. Virtual location types like production and inventory loss are a counterpart to consume or create stock, like if we find five or more candies crammed into the back of a shelf. Lucky us. Raw materials for manufacturing are consumed in virtual locations slash production, and a manufactured product will pop out. Damaged locations are thrown into virtual locations slash scrap, which is essentially our trash that can automatically keep track of our inventory losses. Finally, I'll get into what the heck view location is all about. To do that, I'll click on the blue view location for WH to give it a closer look. The location type view is for organizing the hierarchical structure of your stock location. It should not directly contain products. The view location, WH, groups all of the internal locations like receiving docks, quality checkpoints, and packing areas together. Lastly, let's talk warehouses. To do that, I'll go to the configuration subheading and then click on warehouses. This is where all of my warehouses are listed. So, when would a company feel the need to create a new warehouse? Well, they could be setting up a new shop, opening up a distribution center, or getting another warehouse at a new address. To check out how that works with Odoo, let's click New to create a new warehouse for Stealthywood. And let's name it Pop-Up Shop. I also need to create an abbreviated name, so in the short name field, I'll put Pop. For this new warehouse, we gotta make sure to assign a new address too. Since the company address is used by default and different warehouses must have different addresses. To do that, I'll click on the addresses field and select Stealthywood Pop-Up Store from the drop-down menu, which is a contact I created in advance because I'm prepared like that. Awesome, let's go ahead and save this. And then I can click on the internal link arrow button in the address field to open up a contact page. This address over here is automatically used as the warehouse's reception location for all my operations. This address will now also be used on all documents associated with the warehouse, providing precise information about the product's origin. And there you have it. You're all up to speed on the basics of creating warehouses and locations. These concepts will be essential for understanding how to use Odoo inventory. You did great today, Odooers. You deserve to be so proud of yourselves. I'll see you soon.